Tacitus does something else. He keeps to that sort of analytic sequence and gives us a year-by-year count that runs across the divisions that the death and the succession of emperors Denmark came. Why do you think he opted for annals? Genre is absolutely vital, guys. Take this away. So, basic principle. We need to think about genre. Why do authors write in the genres they choose? It's a choice. It's an option. Why did Tacitus choose annals? Yes.
It's important to make the point of the beholders not just the individual emperors.
Well, I totally agree with you that this is sort of an alternative to a history centered on the emperors. What kind of history is he writing? By emphasizing consuls. Absolutely. Annalistic history is the traditional Republican way of thinking about time and temporal sequence. It was the consuls, the two high magistrates, that gave their name to the year when X and Y were consuls. So he elevates the consuls above the emperor in importance. That's what his choice of genre gives him, a Republican way of thinking about the past. Thinking about history, thinking about time. There's a very powerful punch packed into his choice of annalistic historiography as his mode of engagement with a system that has its center elsewhere. Not anymore in the consuls, but the emperors. And he does something else. Who was a consul? Absolutely. He's writing his own history. He's writing a senatorial history centered on the highest office that senators can still reach in the imperial system, the consulship.